Donna, who had the most impact on your painting?
Well, my grandmother took up painting when she was 65, and she did oils. And I always painted, and so she gave me her old oils, and that little picture of that little girl. And I did oils when I was first painted. And the little girls from the Northern Tissue used to have children on the Northern Tissue bags. That's what that little girl's from. And then I had my other first one I sold in high school at an art show. It was a harbor scene. It was water with clouds, and that's actually hanging in the guest house. But she was my first influence. And then I went to art school, and I didn't really paint a whole lot then. And then I lived in Chicago. I didn't really paint too much. I didn't paint hardly at all when I was living in Chicago. And then when we moved to California and I was pregnant is when I started painting children's things and, I don't know, children's things. And then I did that, and I always painted children's things and sold my artwork in San Francisco and in Marin County. And I did my first Sausalito Art Festival in 1977. When and then I went back to art school and studied illustration. And that's when I really learned to draw. I mean, I could draw. This is, you know, basically that means you have to know how to draw to do that. That's not like throwing paint down here. That's a true drawing. So is this the painting of the watercolor painting over there. Those are of the scene in Mendocino. Those are all in this one, which I think is really well painted, and I have to finish it. It's San Francisco, and this is the Palace of Fine Arts. And this is, you have to know how to draw to do that. But the clouds are a completely different thing. They're like fun and more, you know, fluffy. And you can make them any way you want. You don't even have to cut, you know, you don't have to do it exactly like what you see it, right? And you can make it stormy if you want. So my color palette is already kind of made up with my blues, and I'll make up my own gray from this deep mauve purple and brown. I believe that's sepia.
Kind of a puce.
And this is a really weird watercolor. It's a brownish. I can't remember the name of it. It's Daniel Smith. I had the names on the sides, but they've worn off. This is purple, but this one's this mauve-y thing, and this is what I love to mix brown with. And I've got different browns over here, sepia, and this makes a nice gray. And plus, you can also put some of this ultramarine in it, and you get yourself. And if you want to tone it down, you can put some more of the lighter brown in it, and that'll give you a nice gray. Ochery color from that you see in the clouds, because clouds are not all just white. You understand? I'm just learning to paint clouds.